I'm going to show you how to create great MATLAB figures for your scientific paper or your PhD thesis. I'm using dark mode for your convenience, but any figures that you produce is going to have black line on a white background, as you would expect. This is a figure you would typically produce with MATLAB. You have some data, you plotted it, and you use the save button on the figure that appeared on the screen. The issue is the data doesn't really stand out. It's all a bit lost in the general figure. The font size is really too small and it's difficult to read the text. And then you have different fonts between the axis and the labels that doesn't make it look so professional. And the worst part is it's likely you're going to create several different kinds of figures, resize a window, save them, and then when you're going to create your paper or your PhD thesis, every figure looks kind of bad because they don't look the same from one to the next. This can be solved by the code I'm going to show you, and the same figure that I show you with the basic MATLAB technique can look so much nicer when you apply these simple rules. Now we are going to walk through the entire code, so don't be scared when you see it. This is the entire code that I'm using. The first part is where I create the figure, it is what you are going to do with your own research. And the second chunk of code can be copy-pasted after every single one of your figures to make it look really amazing. And if you consistently use this code, you can actually produce a whole range of figures that are all going to be compatible with each other. The first line is very important. When you create your figure, you have to save the handle in a variable and you're going to call it hfig. Always do this, that way you can always copy-paste the code at the bottom and it can always be used to format your figure. You then create some data, here I'm creating some random data, and you're going to plot it. I'm plotting my data with a pretty color on a line width of 1.5. You can choose the type of line width you want, but I recommend you make your lines a bit thicker so that they stand out some more. As you can see on the screen, it looks prettier. Finally, in the command, I'd set the display name. We can discuss it in another video, but that's a very good way to use legends in MATLAB with a new language that they have developed. Finally, I give my figure some labels, so I now have nice data that stands out really well with labels. I did not use the LaTeX interpreter because we can do that all in one line and you don't need to keep writing interpreter LaTeX in every single one of the lines where you use the LaTeX interpreter. Now we are moving to the very interesting part of the code. Picture width equal 20 is a magical number. I use 20 for all my figures and I recommend you can do as well. You can choose the number you want, but you will never, ever, ever change it anymore. Its value is going to be in centimeters. So 20 is a nice way of having figures that have high quality enough for your PowerPoint presentations and for your papers, but not too heavy. The height-weight ratio is something that you can play with. I use 0.65 because I like figures that are a bit more broad than high. I find that more readable, but it's really a question of taste, and this you can always play with as you make figures, especially if you have several subplots in your figure. The next line is where the magic begins. We are using the function findall, so we can find the property fontsize in hfig. So in our whole entire figure, we are going to find every time there is a font size property. Then with the set function, we can actually define and set font size to a value that we want. I use 17 in my thesis. I use 21 in this presentation. You will see later that we are going to see how we can adjust it to something that suits your need. As you can see from the figure, the data and the labels already pop out a lot more. It already looks a lot better. The next step is optional, but I always like to put box property to off. So again, I use findall and set on hfig to set the box to off. It's turning off the box for both all the figures and also for the legends. I find that the design is a little bit more minimal and a little bit nicer to read, but it might not be what you need. So this line you can take away. You just make a design decision for your own work. The next line is really cool. We are going to set the interpreter to LaTeX throughout the whole figure. It's a great line because you don't need to do it for every single bit of text that you have in your figure. It's going to affect the title, the legend, the axis, the labels all at once. And it's going to make all of the text use the same font, Computer Modern from LaTeX. However, as you can see, it is not working on the ticks of the axis. So we need to use the second line when you set the property Ticklabel interpreter to LaTeX as well. And now our figure is already looking very polished. Now we want to save it into something very nice that we can use to work with. So we are going to set our figure to a certain size based on the picture width that we decided above and the height weight ratio that we set and that we can play with. Now the issue is that if we were going to save our figure now in PDF with this information, we actually change the size of the window, but the print function that MATLAB uses doesn't use the print function from the window to create the figures, so we end up with a figure that is way too high and distorted. What we need to do is to tell MATLAB that we wanted to print with the same size of the figure as we showed it in the pop-up window in MATLAB. So we get the position of the figures that we set beforehand and we reuse this information to tell MATLAB to set the printer correctly. The last two lines show you how to print your figure either in a PDF format or in a PNG format. In my opinion, you want to save the figures as PNG if you are going to use that in a PowerPoint or maybe in a Word document. But if you use LaTeX, I recommend you use PDF figures. A lot of people recommend to use EPS, but I don't like this format because you cannot preview it in Windows and it's always a pain if you want to see what type of figures you created. However, when you create a PDF and insert it into a LaTeX document, it is just as easy. You keep the property that comes from having vectors and the precision if you zoom in the figure, but you can very easily reuse it even in a Word document when you need to. The print function is also very powerful if you wanted to print a series of figures by changing things as we did. For example, as I did with this presentation, you can just make a loop on the file name in the print function and then create a whole series of figures that are all going to be consistent with each other, all have the same size, all have the same color schemes, and really look polished and pulled together. Now, I told you to use picture widths of 20. Now you need to decide with your life what value you're going to have in all of your work, and we are going to work on the font size. I'm taking LaTeX as an example because that's what I'm using in my PhD thesis, but you can of course use the same logic with Word. This is an example of a bit of random text with a figure put into it. I use a font size of 21 in this presentation because when I zoom out on the figure to put it in the document, the text of the figure and the text of the document are exactly the same size. And because MATLAB creates figure in computer modern, when you turn the LaTeX interpreter on and LaTeX uses computer modern, we actually have the same font. If you're using Word or if you're using other documents, I would advise that you use computer modern, Serif, everywhere you can, because it's almost impossible to change font on MATLAB, so it's easier to adapt your whole document to have all the figures look nice together. It's an open source font that you can download on the internet very easily and install, and then you can use it across every single program. So even if you use GIMP or Photoshop to make adjustments, you can use computer modern to add fonts that are going to look good. Here I'm going to walk through the different font sizes. Font size 10 is the default for MATLAB, and as you can see, it's way too small in my document. But that's what you would get if you use the save function on MATLAB as a baseline. If I increase to 16, it already looks better, but it's still kind of an ASO because visually you notice that the font size is not working so well. And 21 is a font size that works really well for the figure. I'm going to show you as well what happens when we go to bigger font sizes. The figures really stand out more. For example, with a font size of 32, we have a very large figure that is too big for the text. I plotted it because I want to show you something. You can use very large font sizes on many figures and it's still going to look okay and adequate. MATLAB handles it actually quite well. And with the code I showed you, you can print your figure with the font size that you want, then increase the font size, then print it again to be used, for example, in a slide presentations. This is an easy way to make figures that are going to look great on a poster presentation or in a PowerPoint presentation. Now, I did not touch on the legends in this video or on the color schemes you can use to have your figures look great. I'm available in the comments if I can answer your questions. I will do so. If you have wishes for more explanation on figures, please tell me, and thank you so much for watching.